President Obama sounded optimistic in Denver today as he signed the $787 billion stimulus package into law, but it wasn't all sunshine and rainbows. The president made it very clear we are not nearly out of the woods yet. Take a listen.
We will need to do everything in the short term to get our economy moving again, while at the same time recognizing that we have inherited a $1 trillion deficit, and we need to begin restoring fiscal discipline and taming our exploding deficits over the long term. None of this will be easy. The road to recovery will not be straight. We will make progress, and there may be some slippage along the way. It will demand courage and discipline. It will demand a new sense of responsibility that's been missing from Wall Street all the way to Washington. There will be hazards and reverses, but I have every confidence that if we are willing to continue doing the critical work that must be done by each of us, by all of us, then we will leave the struggling economy behind us and come out on the other side more prosperous as a people.
Theoretically, something you'd think everybody could get behind, but you'd be wrong about that. CNN national political correspondent Jessica Yellen has more on the party that's out of power right now and may be ready to pounce.
President Obama is taking a victory lap.
We have begun the essential work of keeping the American dream alive in our time.
And so are the Republicans who voted against the stimulus.
Every Republican in the House voted against this bill for one simple reason. We believe that this Congress can do better.
In this new internet video, House Republicans brag that their united opposition to the stimulus will launch their political comeback as fiscal conservatives. Many believe they were hurt by years of massive budgets under President Bush. The last year Republicans ran Congress, they backed almost $1 trillion in discretionary spending.
I think they're back fighting on issues that they're comfortable with. And at the end of the day, their constituencies, their donors, their supporters are going to be very pleased with someone's looking out for tax dollars.
But Democrats see something more sinister, that Republicans want the president's stimulus plan to fail, that they are in fact banking on failure. Rush Limbaugh led the charge.
I don't want this to work. I hope he fails.
Republicans are first betting against Barack Obama, which is a bad bet, believe me. And second, I think they're betting against recovery. Rush Limbaugh says it. I want this president to fail. And that seems to be what their bet is.
It's a familiar refrain. Not long ago, Democrats were the ones accused of banking on failure when they opposed increased spending in Iraq.
The House trying to tie the hands of our troops and try to ensure, frankly, failure in Iraq.
For years, opposing the war in Iraq was a political risk for Democrats who were struggling to win over those security voters. Now, Democrats believe Republicans are doing some gambling of their own by standing nearly united against President Obama's economic agenda.
Even if they're right, it's hard to see them prospering by simply saying no.
But Republican leaders say they're saying no on principle, not on politics.
It is painful to see the recession and to hear about jobs being terminated and individuals losing their jobs, and we all want something done. It boils down to being, what's the right thing to do?
So far, the numbers are with the Democrats. The latest Gallup poll shows support for the stimulus has grown 7% since President Obama hit the road promoting it.
Bottom line, Democrats now own this stimulus, and the fate of both parties rests with the success or failure of this massive bill. Jessica Yellen, CNN, Washington.
And joining me here in New York to talk about this battle of political wills and purposes, we've got Daily News columnist Errol Louis, also Republican strategist Ed Rollins, both CNN contributors joining me. And in Washington, Time Magazine editor-at-large Mark Halperin is with us as well. Guys, welcome everybody. Mark, let me start with you. How much do Republicans run the risk of looking like they want President Obama to fail?
Well, they run a big risk there, Campbell. I'd like to answer first, though, not as a political analyst, but as an American. As an American, I think both parties are making a mistake by not going the extra mile on the stimulus bill and in their rhetoric now to try to find common bipartisan solutions. I think the Republican Party is making a mistake if they're worried about political advantage. As a political analyst, I think it's also a bad idea. I think if they came forward with real plans to cut the deficit, rather than just being the party of being against Obama. That might be courageous and effective. But all they're doing now is saying no. They're doing it without leaders, without breakthrough ideas. I think it's a big mistake.
Do you agree with that, Ed?
Well, first of all, now that we've committed this amount of money, we all certainly hope it works. We don't have another round. And obviously, as Americans, we all want it to work. We want it to work for your children, my children. I think the difference, though, is we weren't invited into the process. And it's nice to say, come forward with proposals. We were never invited in the room. And the president invited a few to the Super Bowl. He made a couple speeches to them. But until we have the opportunity to govern or the opportunity to really offer proposals, we're not going to pounce. We basically go out and try and protect the taxpayers' money and make sure that these programs don't become permanent programs.
But how do you explain this rift between your Republican governors? Because they like this plan. They are supporting this plan locally. They need the help.
They're sitting there with very significant shortfalls. Governor Schwarzenegger's got the biggest shortfall of all, $45 billion.
But aren't they the guys on the front lines of this crisis?
They're on the front line, but they're not basically, they have overspent their own money and they have to reset the priorities. Is the federal government going to take over all state programs? In this bill, we are now going to build for the first time the federal level local schools. We've never done that before. Now, are we going to stop at this bill or are we going to always build local schools? And that's a $100 billion add-on here to a $59 billion federal program. So it's a question of, do we do things in the short run, and are we basically able to get away from this 2 years, 4 years, 8 years? Otherwise, the federal government's going to take on every role in the country.
Well, and Errol, to Ed's point, you know, you had the press secretary, White House press secretary, not even willing to rule out another stimulus plan.
That's right. I mean, economists across the board are saying not if, but when. That when the president says that there's $2 trillion missing in demand and that the government has to step in, what he's really talking about is that he expects $2 trillion worth of stimulus to be necessary at some point. So, yeah, we're certainly going to see it again, and we're going to have this argument all over again.
We have another $1 trillion. I mean, next week he presents a budget. Now, most of the budget was made up by Bush, but it's his budget. It'll have an excess of $1 trillion shortfall, meaning that the spending will exceed by over $1 trillion, as it did this year. There's $2 trillion more that's being spent and borrowed than we have today in the game.
Well, Mark, let me ask you, you know, you hear him talk so much about transparency, so much about accountability, but when you're talking about this kind of money, I mean, how on earth do you make concessions for that? I mean, how are you transparent when you're when you're into the trillions?
Somewhere, Campbell, there's a 16-year-old student reporter who will be investigative reporters 10 years down the road, still investigating how all this money was spent. It's a lot of money. It's going to go out. There are going to be problems. I think one thing that Barack Obama is doing that's politically smart and is substantively smart is saying to the American people, we're going to have to experiment. We're going to have to try different things. And he's got to balance optimism and some caution. There's no way there's not going to be waste, fraud, and abuse with all this money gushing out of Washington. Republicans would be smart to be a watchdog on that, but so would Democrats.
So how much time does he have, Errol, I'll ask you this, to maneuver? Because some of this money is getting to people right away, but by and large, it's going to take some time before it really gets out there, before people start feeling the effects of this.
Sure, it will take some time. Yeah, he owns it now. I think the cycle to look at are the midterm elections. I think by election season next year, he'll want to be able to point to some results in key states. And so that becomes a political calculation, but also an economic one. There's a lot of discretion that's going to be here, especially with the education funding. They're going to direct that money to where they think it can do the most good to expand, I think, the Democratic political base going into next year. That would be my advice to the president, and I assume that his advisors are telling him that.
All right, guys, we got to end it there. Thank Ed you. Rollins, Errol Louis, and Mark Halperin, thanks. Appreciate it. No man is an island, the poet said, and that's never sort of truer during hard times. Tonight's story of the ripple effect takes us to Florida, where a former soldier is hoping for a change of luck. And you also, we should let you know, can be part of tomorrow's No Bias, No Bull interview with financial expert Susie Orman. Submit a video question now at cnn.com/Campbell.